Good morning, YouTube. What is going on, guys? It is Sunday, May something, but I'm going to be taking you guys through a full day of eating during this lock-in. I'll show you what I've been eating, kind of because I've been home the majority of the time and not going out to eat. So we're going to be starting off with meal one. It's a little bit after 5 a.m. I woke up at like 4:40-ish today and I had to shoot another video, a little physique update. I am 220 right now, 30 pounds up since the stage, but I definitely feel good here and I'm feeling pretty lean for 220. You can probably see in the next video or the before picture, video for that, or just follow me on Instagram. So we're gonna be having breakfast, and what I'm having is a cereal that I found that is amazing and I'm super happy about it. So there's Rice Krispie Treats cereal. There's just pretty much like Rice Krispies and marshmallows. And I think like the actual Krispies part of it is sweeter too. So it's really tasty. And then we got, of course, two scoops, PE Science Frosted Chocolate Cupcake. So we got two scoops of that. We made it into a pudding. So we got a little bit of quick digesting carbs right now. And then we got the protein. I was going to say that I'm having these I like a low fat cereal for the morning, like get some carbs in. And then because I'm going to be training in a couple hours. But I'm probably also gonna have a couple of those little Fiber One brownies because they taste really good. But then that kind of defeats the purpose of like a sugary cereal in the morning. But it is what it is. So I'm gonna be having that. And the overall goals for this day of eating, I just put my calories up from 3150 to 3200 calories per day. And with my Apple Watch, my baseline activity level is 400. I take my watch off when I train. And then I wear it when I do my jump training and if I walk the dog. So if I'm over 400, I got to eat those calories back. That gives me a little bit extra control. Like if you have a really busy lifestyle, then I probably recommend doing something like this. Because if you have a really busy job and then the next day, like you're watching Netflix the majority of the day or just chilling, you may burn like 500 less calories. So you may not need to eat that much. So this helps me stay on track of that and kind of like maintain those like fluctuations and stuff. So the goal for this month, because it's very early in May and I'm like 220 in the beginning, is going to be gaining another 1% body weight to 222 to 223 pounds. So that's 1 to 1.5% body weight, because I'm about, well, I'm 220, but that's in like the 200 range. That's easier math. So that's the plan. My macros are going to be 250 protein. I try to keep my fat between like 50 and 65 in most cases. So that's around that 0.3 grams of fat per pound. And then also pretty much I just fill the rest with carbs, which should be around 400 or so carbs. But I'm likely going to go over protein because that's a minimum for me. At least 250, so sometimes it's like 280. And then fat, usually I'm good at keeping that where it needs to be, but then carbs are gonna be pretty high. Also, if I'm really active today, they're probably gonna be higher. So taking you guys along with me on this day, this beautiful day of eating, and then let's eat some stuff. Alrighty, so sitting down in the dining room, so we're official today. So this is the meal that I'm having. So again, we got the, look at these Rice Krispie things, they're so cool, like the little marshmallow action. And then we got that pretty much in like a little bit of pudding, and it's awesome. So I'm gonna be eating this, and then I got two of these. I'll show you them both. I think these are pretty much the best, but the Fiber One little brownies are delicious. So we got some protein, some carbs, pretty low fat, except like the brownies have like 2 to 3 grams each. The macros will be down below, but I'm gonna eat this. Gonna have probably a 3D energy, and then I'm gonna head up and get some work done. And then I'm gonna be training around 7, 8-ish, and we'll see how that one goes. But I'll probably be eating a little bit more carbs before then as well. So if you're wondering why your macros get messed up at the end of the night and like your macros and calories don't really link up too well, it's probably, this is one of the culprits, the Fiber One kind of stuff. So in this case, it says 70 calories, right? Fiber, insoluble fiber, is pretty much calorie free, so you can technically kind of subtract that, but then that really overcomplicates things. But this is why I like doing the math at the end of the day of like your fats, proteins, carbs, multiplying your carbs and protein by 4 calories per gram, and then your fat by 9 calories per gram to get your total calories. This is why that number may be different from like what you see on my fitness belt. So these are 17 carbs, 2 protein, so 19 times 4, that's 76. So 76 calories just from the fats and, I mean the protein and carbs alone. You're already over the 70 calories you tracked this for. And then it's 3 grams of fat as well. So that's 97 calories. You're tracking it as 70 calories. That's 27 calories more that, I mean, technically I would track this as. So mainly just kind of like be consistent. But when you track your macros, this is kind of one of those inconsistencies you're taking account of. So that's why you kind of track your macros versus tracking your just calories alone, because there's a lot of other variables. But yeah, so this is one of the reasons I recommend just hitting like a normalized carb amount and then having a normal like fiber amount, so you don't have to like kind of mess with, okay, do I subtract those fiber calories, do I have to subtract that, do I add that, is that insoluble fiber or is that soluble fiber? You don't have those kinds of like really nuanced details. You can just kind of like keep those two numbers relatively consistent. There's going to be minimal wavering, so that's how I recommend to do it without being overwhelmed with all the inconsistencies between different brands and stuff. All right, guys, so it is now 7:30, so I'm about to be getting into training. Probably by 8 or so, I'm probably just gonna go up, get changed, grab a drink, and then head into the gym. So what I'm gonna be having right now is just 200 grams of rice and some soy sauce on that. So I usually put a good amount of soy sauce on it just to get some sodium in before training. It's gonna help shuttle the carbs into your muscle cells, and also it's gonna help you get some pretty sweet pumps. So I would definitely recommend trying out throwing in some pre-workout sodium into your pre-workout meal, and that should help a little bit with your training. Also, gonna be throwing down probably like 3 scoops of high volume. As you guys know, I'm sponsored with PE Science, so use Kevin to save 15%. This is my favorite pre-workout. It's non-stim, so I'll usually, instead of getting like pre-workout with like caffeine already in it, I'd rather go with like a drink on the side. Maybe it's coffee, maybe an energy drink, and then I'll go with a non-stim pre-workout. It does the same job, but I usually like sip on my caffeine throughout my workout instead of just like taking it all right before. So I'm gonna knock out this meal, let the dogs in, because they're doing their business. You guys haven't seen the dogs yet today. Hey buddy, there's Elonk just grazing, and Yumster over yonder. So I'm gonna get to training now, see you guys in a bit. Training is complete. So did a little bit of training in the garage, hit the, oh gosh, what do I do? Bench press. We did some bench, some shrugs. We did some bent upright rows, so lots of trap action, some lunges, RDLs, and also, crap, front goblet squats, kind of like a 2 dumbbell goblet squat. So it was a really good workout, a lot of lower body, a lot of trap action, because I don't really have those. So we're gonna have my post-workout meal. And I'm really actually, surprisingly, I'm not that hungry. But since I'm training like twice a day, you guys saw like I'm usually doing like jump training. That's something that's more like intensity focused. So like you don't want to go into a jump training session like fatigued, because then you're not going to be able to jump very well. And then other workouts, it's just get it done. So like in a dieting phase, you're doing cardio. It's like just get it done. Just burn those calories. So you don't necessarily have to be like glycogen full for those kinds of things. But for like jumping, you want to be. Today's second session is like core and mobility, so I don't necessarily need to focus or like really worry about my glycogen stores being full. When you post-workout, when getting in like a lot of carbs, like you only have to stress that like post-workout window like a lot if you're training twice a day. And especially if that second session is more intensity focused, like if it's strength training, if it's jump training, if it's like mobility and maybe like core work or like light steady state cardio, you don't have to worry about it as much. But for me, my second workout of the day is gonna be core mobility. So not too worried about it. But the other benefit of getting a good meal in like post training, when you're training, you're breaking down muscle tissue. So you're in a kind of like a breakdown mode, catabolism. What's gonna flick that switch into anabolism, having food in there. So then your body has enough, it has nutrients to start building up, and it also has that stimulus of like, okay, food's coming in, let's start rebuilding. As opposed to like just carrying that catabolic stimulus without giving any food afterwards, you kind of may stretch that out. So that's a benefit of a post-workout meal. So usually what I would do is go like low fat, high carb, and high protein in this meal. So it's boring, but and since I'm not too hungry, it's more like calorie dense stuff. So I got some Lucky Charms and some more protein pudding, and those are unicorn Lucky Charms. If I can show you a unicorn, there's one. That's a unicorn Lucky Charm. So I get like 70 grams of that and like 50 grams of protein worth of, so two scoops. So you're gonna be having this, got my next training session later. And I checked the freezer for what veggies we got in store. I'm out of peas. I'm on a peas wave, which I really like it, and all we got is broccoli, and broccoli kind of is gross. So I'm gonna eat this up and then I'll talk to you guys at the next meal. What's going on, guys? So it's now about noon. I'm gonna be doing the second training session. So this is gonna be kind of for the goal of getting my vertical jump up, which is something I'm focusing on this quarantine. So today is, it's usually like three plyometric days, and in between those is two mobility and core days. So that's kind of like the benefit of doing this kind of training, is it's making me focus on doing core and working on mobility. So today, gonna knock that out. Should only be like 20 minutes or so, and then probably gonna have this next meal. So I'm kind of hungry right now, but I don't want to eat a big meal and then try to do like sit-ups and dead bugs. So I'm gonna do this. So you guys just saw me do a little bit of those awkward rocking dead bugs. Those are intense. Try to keep like your hand behind your head and then your elbow on your knee, and then like the other side you reach. Probably can do it better than I can, but those are pretty tough. What I'm eating now, oh yeah, and there was a couple other things. So kind of like side planks, we had regular planks, and then a couple mobility based things. But now I'm gonna eat, which I'm excited. So we got some 96.4 ground beef from Piedmontese. We got 300 grams of cooked rice under there. You probably couldn't see it. And, oh, I forgot to make a joke and say I was gonna have protein powder again in cereal. I missed out. But then we also have a package of green beans. I said I thought we only had broccoli, but thank the Lord we've actually got some green beans, because I, for some reason, I'm just not having it with broccoli ever since dieting. I would much rather have peas, because they just like really mix in with like ground beef and rice real nice. So I'm gonna throw this into the microwave again and then I may eat it.
All right, so it's ready. We got this behemoth of food, and this has some weight to it. Like, that's pretty large. So is this thing of food. So we got some ground beef and a bunch of that green beans. They're actually not bad. Usually, like, frozen, steamable frozen bags of asparagus is terrible compared to grilled asparagus. But the green beans actually come out really good. But here is, we're gonna go in there. That's the rice and the ground beef. So it's actually in there, and I'm gonna hit it up with some soy sauce. So right now, just chilling in this room. It's a Sunday. Usually I have some stuff to get done. But I mean, today's pretty chill. Last week I was experimenting with getting ads up and running on like Facebook, working with a couple of those things. It was exciting. It was new territory, but now it's kind of done and the system's ready. And now it's just like, okay, how much are we going to, put into it? So it's been pretty chill right now. I'm just going to watch some YouTube. I'm watching, this guy who does watch videos, Teddy B, and he's doing a piece on movement watches first. He's really into the movements of watches. I just think watches are interesting right now. So watching this, gonna be eating this, relaxing a bit, probably gonna get some ice cream at some point while I'm watching some stuff, but I'll keep you guys tuned with that. But I'm gonna eat some of these green beans because vegetables, guys. All right, guys, so now favorite part of the day, gonna have the best enlightened flavor. So as you know, if you've been watching me, I love ice cream, probably my favorite food. And I pretty much have a pint a day of enlightened ice cream because it's got some 20 grams of fiber. This one actually has 16, and it's usually relatively high protein and low calories. So best flavor, movie night. And the way, because I'm impatient, so the way to get it softened quickly instead of waiting 5 to 10 minutes is you invert it. You take the film off, invert it, put it in the microwave for 20 to 30 seconds. This one, definitely do 20 seconds because I definitely overdid it on the, what's it called? On the microwaving. But the best flavor, check. Yeah, that's super soft serve now. Bang, bang. So butter, popcorn, flavored ice cream, caramel, swirl, and then chocolate chips. It's awesome, so definitely try it. If you ever find it in your store, definitely try it out. But I'm still watching YouTube, so I'll check in with you guys when I eat again. What do you want? What do you want, Yumster? Is it that time? Is it that time? Oh. So we are about to get a walk on, and this is also the cheat code light that I use. So, cheat codes, natural light. So we are gonna get ready for a walk, Yumster and the Ewok. Out here taking a walk with the pups. It's 77 degrees in Jersey, so trying to get a tan too. So taking them out, getting some steps in, which means I get to eat a little bit more later. All right, so the dogs got their exercise in and they're super happy about it. Right, guys? That's a yes. So we're gonna be having the next meal. It's something around 4 o'clock. Usually I start winding down for bed 7:30 if I'm not too busy with something. And today has not been a very busy day. It's been a boring day actually. So I'm gonna be finishing out the ground beef that was in the fridge. So we got, it's 10 ounces raw, so it's 7.5 ounces cooked. And then we got 200 grams of white rice on top of that. So quarantine survival guide, especially if you are in a calorie surplus, something that's gonna do you a lot of good is having a rice cooker on at all times and just always being stocked with some carbs, some pretty much near fat-free carbs if you're trying to keep your fat down. So I'm gonna be eating this up. I think it's almost 60 grams of protein because it's 2.5 servings of that ground beef. And then we got this delicious stuff for some kettle corn popcorners. This actually has a little bit of fat. It's got 4 grams of fat per serving. So for me, only trying to keep it around 60,
roughly 60 grams per day. That's actually, that can add up if I have like three servings. So here's two servings of that. It's the kettle corn, which is delicious. And if you guys have been longtime viewers, I was obsessed with popcorners, the jalapeno cheddar flavor. And I think that was like a year ago. Phenomenal, so good stuff. I need to restock my pantry with it though, so I gotta brave the supermarket. But I'm gonna be eating this up, and then probably gonna do a little bit of reading of Alan Aragon's research review, and then I'm not too sure. May go up, get a little bit of things done, and then I'll let you guys know what is next on the list. But I'm gonna eat this, it's gonna be delicious, but actually I'm not gonna have that rice and beef plain, I'm gonna throw some soy sauce on it. So, gonna get to that. All right, so last meal of the day. Gonna be have some carbs and a little bit of protein. So for once, not Frosted Chocolate Cupcake, but we have the peanut butter cup pea science, one scoop of that. And then I wanted to have a bunch of these Skinny Pop little cinnamon wafers, but ran out. So we got some more Lucky Charms action, and I put a unicorn on the top just so you guys could see. That's the unicorn. Because you can obviously make out that's a unicorn. Only the best of quality. And then that's going to be the last meal of the day. So that's going to finish out our day, which means we are at 60 grams of fat. So pretty much where I wanted to be. 439 grams of carbs and 280 grams of protein. So that is because I'm at like 623 activity right now. If you can see that. Yeah, so 623 right now. Probably by the time I go to bed, it's going to be like 650. So that's 250 more than my baseline. So 3200 plus that 250 is 3450, which we just about hit once you math out all that stuff. And also, I think we hit 60 grams of fiber. So we got the 14 grams per 1,000 calories accomplished. And we got some vegetables in. So very happy about that. That's going to do it for today's video. Thanks for hanging out with me for today. So like, comment, subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Keep it flexible. I'm out.